On 17th July 2019, all the eyes of the Indian football fans were on the draw for the second round of the joint Asian Cup and FIFA World Cup qualifiers. From the total of 5 pots, India was in the 3rd pot, and at the end of the draw, India was placed in Group A alongside Bangladesh, Oman, Afghanistan and Asian champions Qatar. The expectation from team was to at least finish third in the group and give a tough fight to Oman for second place. Now let's see how the Indian team's qualifiers journey panned out. On 5th September 2019, the Indian team embarked on a qualifiers journey against Oman. In jam-packed Indira Gandhi Athletic Stadium, Sunil Chhetri provided an early celebration moment for fans by scoring a clever combination set-piece goal with Brendan Fernandes. Indian team defended well until the 82nd minute when Almandar scored an equalizing goal, and 8 minutes later he netted the winning goal. In the end, the match finished 2-1 in Oman's favor. For the next match, the Indian team flew to the Asian champions' home. In a match against Qatar, Indian team would play without their talisman Sunil Chhetri as he was suffering from an injury. India went onto the field with a defensive mindset and parked the bus in front of their goal. The Indian team was able to maintain their shape throughout the match. However, when the Qatari team did break the Indian defense, then Gurpreet Singh Sandhu was superb in between sticks. In the end, the Indian team grinds out a nil-nil draw against the Asian champions. After playing a draw against Qatar, the confidence of the Indian team seems to be high. Also, in the first two fixtures, they had played against stronger teams, and now they had relatively weaker opponents in Bangladesh and Afghanistan for next two fixtures. But the reality was quite opposite. Before the match against Bangladesh, pillar of the Indian team defense, Sandesh Jingan, sidelined for almost a year due to an ACL injury. But one good news India had that Sunil Chhetri was fit to play for 90 minutes. On match day, Bangladesh had a clear game plan, sit deep and hit India on the counter attacks. On the other hand, Steamax men seemed like they did not have any plan. On the 42nd minute, Bangladesh silenced a near 60,000 plus home crowd at Salt Lake Stadium. After the Bangladesh goal, the Indian team was struggling to find an equalizer goal until Brendan's in-swinging ball met the Adil's head at the near post and the ball nestled into the net to level the score in the 88th minute. The match ended at a 1-1 scoreline and India barely managed to get 1 point where they were supposed to get the all 3 points. 1 month later, on 14th November 2019, the Indian team flew to Tajikistan to play against Afghanistan. India started the match well by keeping the majority of the possession, but for the first 45 minutes, they were unable to test the rivals' goalkeeper. In the added time of the first half, Afghanistan scored the first goal and it came from India's exposed left wing. The Indian team was trailing by one goal till the injury time when from a corner, Brendan provided an outswinging ball inside the box and Dongal headed the ball into the net. It was a repeat performance from India, just like against Bangladesh, when India struggled against a team they should have comfortably beaten on paper. Both the team in the end settled for a draw. 5 days later, India played their second match against Oman. Mohsen scored the only goal of the game and took all the 3 points and Oman into the second position in their group. After losing to Oman, India with just 3 points from 5 games was now mathematically out for topping the Group A and could only finish second. But that would require Oman to lose their all the remaining games and for India to win all their remaining matches. The remaining games, which are supposed to happen in 2020, were postponed to next year because of the coronavirus pandemic. Also, the Indian team did not play a single friendly match in 2020. On 12 March 2021, Asian Football Confederation confirmed the centralized venue for the remaining games of the Asian Cup and FIFA World Cup qualifiers, which was scheduled to take place from 31 May to 15 June. In May, The Indian team was supposed to hold a one-month-long camp in Kolkata before going to Qatar, but it cancelled because of the second wave of coronavirus. At that time, many countries were imposing a travel ban on India, so the Indian football team rushed to Qatar 2 weeks earlier than scheduled. This time, several new faces, Akash Mishra, Opuya, Suresh Singh, Liston Colasio, Ishan Pandita, Sana Singh and Bipin Singh were included in 28-man squad. Also this time around, the pressure on Igor Stimac was considerably high as he had only one victory in last 12 games. In addition to this, after losing 6-0 to UAE, there was a rumor that AFF is going to sack Stimac no matter what the result comes in next 3 games. Finally, after 18 months, India played their 6th match of qualifiers against Qatar. India fielded a defensive 5-4-1 formation and it was clear that India was going to defend for 90 minutes. India played most of the match with 10 men as Rahul Beke was sent off in 17th minute. India conceded the goal in 33rd minute, but after that, Indian team maintained their shape and Gurpreet Singh was brilliant in between sticks and helped India to end the match with a respectful scoreline. 4 days later, the next match was against Bangladesh. India starts the game with an attacking mindset and had a majority of possession. However, the Indian team was miserable in the attacking third for the first 45 minutes. Bipin Singh and Udanta Singh had a nightmare of a game and both were substituted in half-time. In the second half, Sunil Chhetri scored a brace and provided India's one and only victory of the qualifiers. The last game of the qualifiers was against Afghanistan. It was expected that the Indian team would dominate the match, but the reality was exact opposite. Afghanistan controlled the game and was playing far better than the Indian team. Sometimes it looked like the Indian team went onto the field without any game plan. However, India took the lead thanks to the Afghanistan's goalkeeper mistake. But within 10 minutes, Afghanistan scored an equalizer goal. In the end, both teams shared a point. India ends their qualifiers campaign in 3rd position with 7 points, courtesy of only 1 win and 4 draws. For India, Sunil Chhetri is the top scorer with 3 goals and Brendan Fernandes is the top creator with 3 assists. In our opinion, although India finished 3rd in the group, their performance was really bad in qualifiers. Tell us in the comments what you guys think about India's performance in the qualifiers, and thank you for watching the video.